Hey everyone, today we're doing our initial impressions of Rule the Waves 3, a naval ship simulator focused on construction, design, fleet management, and naval warfare that takes place between the periods of 1890 and 1970. So the dreadnought era all the way to early missile age, as well as aircraft carriers, jets, and early to mid Cold War. Overall, I'm really excited to check it out. I've never played a game like this before, so please feel free to critique my gameplay style. We're going to go more with a series for this video, so our initial impressions will come out on the release day, or first impressions. We're not going to do so much a review, but I feel like we owe our due diligence to this game, especially since we're new to it, and we're going to go this direction with all of our first impressions videos. Now, with all that being said, let's dive right on into it. The first thing I want to talk about is the ability to design a ship. We will not be using that a lot in this first video. Maybe in our later ones we'll take a better look at it. But honestly, I'm not super familiar with the system, so I don't want to talk too much on it. But it is there and it is super fun to use if that's something you want to do. We're going to start with building our ships. I want a battleship. We're going to suggest a name for it. We're going to take the Delaware. We have 15,000 shipyard capacity free of our 30,000. We did start with a small fleet. And then we're going to build one more ship, and it's just going to be a Corvette. We're going to suggest another name, the Sprig. That's super awesome. And so now we have several ships under construction, and they should be laid pretty soon. Under our ships and servers, we have four battleships, a cruiser light, and as well as a Corvette. I want to show you something that I haven't seen anyone talk about at all, but you can actually assign pictures to your ships. So if we click here at this Generate Picture button, we can just kind of click around, select, we can say cruiser, tall, picture, background, we can say generate, and it gives us a picture of our ship, and I think that adds a bit more fun for role play as well as storytelling. So we're going to use that, and if we really wanted to take a look at that, we could double click it, and now our ship has a picture, and that's really fun. We can also see our current, what it has, which is 2 5-inch guns, 2 3-inch guns, 4 2-inch guns. Man, this thing is a beast, and it has a fairly okay armor. And this is what the game view would look like, but I'm more interested in that. Over here, it looks like, is this Italy and Spain looking to pick a fight with us? I want to get some intel on Spain. Spain seems like they want to fight with us all the time. I've played this a bit before, and then I want to get some information on... Let's get some information on the British. Sneaky guys. We'll just start with low on them. Then under research, we can increase our research. We can take this all the way up to high, as well as high. So we're moving our fire control systems to high, and we're moving our armor-piercing projectiles to high. So if anything, we'll at least be able to identify targets faster and then pierce their armor with better weapon systems. Now let's take a look at our doctrine. We could focus on researching these guys, improving our doctrine. I feel like gunnery is really important, as well as night fighting, especially in like the dreadnought era. I'm not going to do it so much now. I've heard it's bad, but honestly, I want to check it out more, and I'm going to go to the manual for that just to see how it plays out. Under the map, here we are. We are America. So if we just start clicking and dragging everything, we can see we have the North American coast. We have the North American West Coast. We can kind of see where our ships currently are. They're in the Central Pacific as well as the North American East Coast. We do have the Panama Canal and the Suez Canal are active in this game. So if we're over here, I wonder if the British are going to let us through if we tried to go that way. And I also wonder if they would let us through down here on the Suez Canal, if that is the Suez Canal. And that's kind of like my initial just go-to. We're going to start taking a look at our turns now because I kind of want to get the game going because that's what I want to show off. So let's hit next turn. And that pop-up always pops up. The president has made aware of our lack of ships in foreign... He does not approve of my admiraling. All right, that's perfectly fine. So if we really wanted to, we could move these ships off. We could just right-click them and go to foreign station. We're going to do that with our two battleships who are currently in the northeast coast. We're going to say move to foreign station. So as you see, there were no changes on that turn. So if you really wanted to focus on ship design or doctrine things, or even if you wanted to run a military exercise, say since we had these two battleships right here, both in the same location, or these two ships in the same location, we could actually run a quick little exercise to show that off. I don't know if you're familiar with this. So if we click on this red flag over here, or fleet exercise, just to work on some of our crew quality, we're going to demonstrate some of our might. And we're going to grab our two battleships that are currently next to each other. So I want to say new division. We're going to add one battleship, add ship. Enemy force, we're going to say new division. We're going to add one battleship, new ship. And it's going to say light, weather, start range, classic, okay. Yep, that's perfectly fine. Fleet exercise will cost 296. That's okay. And then it brings us to this tactical warfare screen where things start popping off. Here's our Michigan. We haven't identified the hostile yet. And one thing that I actually did with this that I thought was pretty cool was I exported the battle data to ChatGP, and I thought that was actually a lot of fun, just to see what ChatGP thought of it. And so, unknown ship sighted. So here we are. We're a good short little distance away. Here's probably this unknown battleship that we're just charging towards. And this is something that we're going to have to work on, so we can kind of change our course if we wanted to. I'm not super, super familiar with changing the course. Oh, so we can just do that. And we just charge him a little bit. We can also just hit play to let this play out. And it just plays a few minutes. It plays a few turns. So if we hover over each one of these, turn, run 5 minutes, run hours, just run in general. So we could just hit the run button. Does that have a hotkey? I'm not sure what that hotkey is. So we could change our course a little bit and try and get closer to this guy. The Michigan's hunting down the Michigan. We're going to just go pause and just play a turn. And then we instantly begin opens firing. So the Michigan class is firing on the Michigan class. I know that's kind of repetitive and redundant. So we're going to turn that the volume down a little bit, and we're going to hit play 5 minutes. We're going to continue to play, and we're just going to actually just let this play out because I mostly just wanted to demonstrate this for you guys just to see what's going on. Let's see if we can track this guy down. I kind of wish it would keep that selected for me, because we're just chasing this guy around. It looks like he's trying to run away, and we're just not going to let that happen. We could go maximum and kind of just chase him down at cruise speed 17, and it just looks like he doesn't really want to participate in this fight, which is perfectly okay. It's just a small little fleet exercise, so if we zoom out, we can just see everything going on. And if we wanted to bring it to a conclusion, that's something we could do. We can auto-run the battle and just call it a day. And it just auto-runs ships, just states their limit, and everything kind of just goes, ooh, what are they doing? Everything's just auto-running, and I think that's a lot of fun if you didn't really want to, like, manage this yourself. And it just goes and goes and goes and goes, and this is about as fast as it can go. But I really want to show you how you can export data, because I feel like a lot of people could have a lot of fun with that. So once this battle concludes, we'll take a look at that. We're just going to follow these guys down while they chase each other around the... What is this? The Atlantic? Almost said the Pacific Ocean. That is not correct at all. We need to focus on our naval warfare. And we're just letting these... It looks like we're being chased down by this Michigan class. All right, we just broke contact, which is really, really good. We just need to keep that up. And we hover over these. Sometimes it tells us what they are. Sometimes it doesn't tell us what they are. Tells us our date and time, our minutes, and everything kind of just eventually. Friendly side has no ships left in the scenario. All right, so... Oh, the Michigan is sinking. Here's basically everything that came from it. Ship score negative 8,000. Enemy side, ship score 8,000. So we could close out if that's something we really wanted to do. We can pull all of our reports if that's something we really wanted to do as well. So just let's see if we can generate those here in a moment. And then if we really wanted to do anything, ooh, the Michigan got sunk. We could actually copy. Oh, if you hold and control, it zooms. I did not know that. We'd actually copy all of this log, take it to ChatGP, paste it in and asked it to define what happened, and kind of run some fun little war game scenarios if that's something we wanted to try later on. So that's the end of our battle. That's exactly what we wanted to showcase, was a fun little tactical exercise. And we don't actually lose a ship in that. It just increases our crew quality. So currently, for the cost of 296 American dollars, they are now good quality. Hopefully they don't get sunk. Then you're always presented with these cool little scenarios that kind of tell you what you want to do. So it's kind of a turn simulator. You just do a few things. Sometimes you go to war. Sometimes you answer a few things. A new liberal government wants to reduce arms expenditure. What is your reaction? And these are really kind of interesting. Sometimes they're just worded really crazily. We can live with this, provided budget tension. This is good. We need to pause from rampant military spending. I mean, it's only March of 1890. This will spell doom for our naval war. Our naval power, we'll be at the mercy of other nations. I think that's really fair. So we're going to say we don't really agree with that. We could view the almanac if that's something we wanted to do. We could also view all of our relations. And things are a bit high right now. Tensions are rising. And they are working on a telescopic sight that but has success, but so far has eluded them. That's perfectly fine. And then each turn message, you get one of these. So we have some ships off the Central Pacific. We can send these to foreign stations if we really wanted to. And we're not even talking about how to like split things into divisions yet. We're just like getting a real, real, real basic understanding of everything that goes on within this game. Unfortunately, our monthly balance is 805, and we currently only have funds of 1,256. So let's hit continue turn. We, with no immediate threat, Congress reduces funding to the Navy. I mean, that's okay. That's okay. A spy from Russia has been discovered. What do we want to do? Give him the maximum publicity and denounce the aggressive policies of the Russia, or handle it quietly and discreetly? I think quietly and discreetly is perfectly fine for pre-Cold War era, especially pre-World War I. We haven't really decided which way we're going to take this. Are we going to be a tyrant authoritarian here in America and try and dominate and paint the map? But we're going to handle it discreetly. We don't really want to take on Russia. You know, positive budget plus positive tension. Congress making mistakes. They're making Admiral Joseph look bad. You know, those Russians did stumble into this U.S. territory. I think we're going with that. We're not playing as a president. We're playing as Admiral Joseph. That's who it asked us to be. All right. Intelligence report. Russia is said to have increased the naval budget. All right, so the U.S. is only the people who want to reduce things. Russia is building a 6-inch coastal battery in the Baltic states. Tensions with Spain increased due to historical enmity. That's fine. Anytime you have the U.S., you're always just hitting heads with Spain for some reason. These goobers over here on the Spain land right here. And then we can kind of just take a look at where we have. Honestly, I think it's really fun because in my last game, somehow I ended up owning North Korea. And I thought that was a really good positioning just to have really early on, especially with Japan over here. The zoom's kind of wonky. I ended up like hanging out with North Korea really early on. I thought that was really cool. So we're just going to go to our next turn. All right. This will bring your funds into the red, which might upset your financial. Yes. Well, no. I don't want to upset anyone. Why are we upset? Can we cancel something? Research. Does that do anything if we take that down to 7%? So we only have $731. So that spending all that money wasn't good. Oh, we're going broke. What if we cancel this dreadnought? Does that give us money back? It does. All right, so we had to halt construction of that dreadnought so we don't go into the negative. Oh, no, everyone hates us. Close. All right, our monthly balance is $87, but we're going back into the positive, so we did have to cancel some of that. Whoa! Germany. All right, we're going to go spy on Germany. Let's see if we can push that over into the war zone. We're going to take some eyes off Britain for a little bit. We're going to take some eyes off Spain. We're going to put some eyes on Russia. We need to know what's going on with these guys. Why are these guys, you know, starting a beef? It's only 1890 right now, so it's not even early World War I. Not a super fan of these goons. All right, chill out over here in Northern Europe. So, with tensions randomly rising, we might find ourselves at war early on. We're at the interwar period. We do need to work on some of our budgeting. We'll do that later on, and then we will kind of hit the next turn. Shipyard experience with class has shortened the construction by the KE by spring by 1 month. All right, tensions with France reduced just due to randomness, and we have more ships in the South American West Coast than our bases can support. I don't understand why they want you to have ships off coast if you don't have bases off coast. Can someone clarify that for me? So if I go to the Northern Pacific, would it consider that foreign shores? But if I go over here to like Imperial Japan or the Central Pacific, would those consider not be foreign? And how do I capture this area right here? So currently it's just the Caribbean. Its owner is neutral. I'd really like to become a warmonger. All right, so Germany's still having beef with us. Our monthly budget is still in the garbage. We're going to have to fix that off the game, and I'll come back to you with how I did that because we are in a really bad spot right now. Oh, so this is one that always pops up, and I kind of want to see it a bit more randomized. Captain Winston B. of B. Illinois has left his wife and moved in with an actress and tarnished his reputation. The scandal is the talk of the Capitol and all the gossip in the columns. I mean, it's early 19... It's the 1990s. I mean, if there's 2001, we'd be like, okay. I mean, it's still not good. I don't like this. And as Admiral Joseph, how do I want to proceed with this? Captain Winston B. of Illinois? Eh, I don't care that much. But no, we're totalitarians. And he was caught outright, and he has betrayed our trust. We cannot have that in my Navy. You need to keep that under wraps. To the gallows with him. To the gallows. All right, they're still working on their telescopic sight, but so far it has eluded them. All right, our monthly budget is popping off a little bit, 103. I wonder what else we need to fix, because we kind of need some money. Research 278 construction is where we're throwing things at. So with all that construction going on, it is not looking good. Can we halt something else? Does it tell us what's halted? It does not tell us what's halted. I know we halted the Delaware, so we can either resume that or accelerate that. I want these cruisers to be done. So I don't know what the effect of... Wow, that one was only 57. So if we actually halt one of these cruisers, let's halt this one that costs less. And let's speed up. Let's resume this one. So now we get more money. I think we're going to need more money to make more decisions. So I'd rather have that money. I mean, one less cruiser, if that's what that is going to be awesome. But we're not going to be super, super concerned about it. Yes to all commanders automatically assigned. So what? Who doesn't have a Oh, no. What's going on? Oh, I forgot to assign a commander. The ambassador from Germany has approached the Minister of the Navy with suggestions that we curb our naval program in the interest of peace and stability. What answer do you recommend? We would rather go to war than agree to naval. I don't think it's too early. I don't want to go to war episode one. So, why doesn't it tell us what this one is? So this one gives us prestige and tension. This one doesn't do, does this one do anything? So we only get to know these two. We will not reduce our naval unilaterally. If they are that nervous, they would call a disarmament council. All right. That's fine. I mean, if nothing passes, maybe the randomness would drop it a little bit. So we are making some progress in our budget. We do have some more money coming in. We could increase our research a little bit. So what happens if we go back to 8? I think we're going to stay sub 10 right now. We could go up to 9 later on. I'm not super excited about this. I mean, our spies are over there, so we can get a look at a few things. And we are working on our battleships. So let's hit next turn. Oh, our top spy has managed to get a hold of the blueprints of a Russian ship B currently under construction. Is this our top spy? Our top men are on it. Our top women are on it. Good job, young lady. Ooh. What? No picture. You bring this to me with no picture. I want to know what it looks like in the dockyard. What kind of intel is this? All right. 4 12-inch guns. That is really powerful. What is that, an 8 7-inch and 8 3-inch? Ooh. Torpedo tubes? 4? Submerged? Do we even have torpedo tubes? Russian battleship? Displacement 11,000 pounds? Tons? I don't know, guys. That's a doozy. Is that like a flagship of their Navy? Or are we just 12-inch belt? 2-inch deck, 10-inch turrets, 4-inch battery, 8-inch CT. What does that even mean? This is fake. This is fake news. This was slipped to us to scare us. Russia is trying to scare us. Bring that spy back to me. Bring that spy back to me now. All right. So I hope that works out for them. That's a doozy of a ship. Germany has laid down a CA Hertha class. All right, Great Britain has commissioned a ship, the Pantheon, and we got blueprints. Do we even have spies? We do have low spies. I think that information was leaked to us. What does my ship have? So it's double the size of what we currently have. Can we just copy that? What? Germany, chillax, bro. Chillax, Germany. What is going on? If we wanted to build a ship, can we take that blueprint? So we don't even get the blueprints, right? So we say battleship, Michigan. How to design a ship? Does it give us blueprints from the ones that we designed? Battleship, dreadnought. Oh, armored cruiser. CA armored cruiser. Makes sense. Not AC. Battle cruiser, suggest names, clear values. Open existing designs. So these are the only designs we have. So we don't get the... Kind of bummed about not getting, what's the point of them, delivering us that information? Can anyone tell me? What's the point of having that information if it's not going to be, leaked into, my ship design? I think that's where it should end up, right? If you disagree, that's fine, too. Is it? We're actually a totalitarian right now. We're pretty authoritarian. All right, Germany needs to chill. We're going to play through one more turn. So what we learned so far, let's actually do our impressions because we've done, I don't know how long it's been. Let's just do our impressions of the first episode. Germany needs to chill out. All right. Russia needs to stop leaking us that fake information it's been leaking us. And Britain needs to slow down with their shipbuilding. Overall, we got our budget back under control. We're kind of reaccumulating some funds. We did halt the construction. Obviously, there are a few things that I'm interested in. Like I said, this is going to be a learn-as-you-play series, but I'm having fun. If I play like this, I will have fun. If I kind of just play min-maxing or trying to overdo my ship or just not have fun, I'm not going to have fun. And I really need to tell myself to have fun with this game in general because I've never played it before, so it's all new to me, and I don't want to take it seriously. So this is not going to be a serious playthrough. This is just going to be fun. This first impressions on the 18th is going to be fun. And I'm going to have a good time, and hopefully we win our war, and we master the tactical battles and get to the Middle Age, because that's really where I want to get my first impressions on. Peace, guys. Like, comment, subscribe.